All right, man, we back. Goodfellas Sports TV in the building. Make sure that subscribe button, bell icon, comment button. It's Raymond in the D. But, yeah, man, people asking the Charlamagne the God interview, his interview with Gucci Mane, going to break up the Breakfast Club. All right? And Angela Yee, you know, unfollowed him on social media, which, you know, to older people, that's much older than me, like, it's not a big deal, but... Now, she's going around doing interviews, and I linked the article in the description where I did an interview with somebody just saying that, you know, basically, Charlamagne had no loyalty interviewing Gucci Mane without them, without their consent. But at the end of the day, how I look at it, Charlamagne's a grown man, all right? Charlamagne's a grown man. If he want to interview Gucci, him and Gucci, cool, cool. Now, I don't know if, you know, him, Angela Yee, and DJ Envy, I don't know if they tight like that. Like, all right, we work together. Cool. You know what I'm saying? But I don't know if they go out kicking, you know, their kids play together or whatever. And obviously, they know some things about each other. You know, they know you got a kid, Envy got a wife, you know, blah, say, blah. And at the end of the day, the real bottom line is, was Charlamagne wrong for interviewing Gucci Mane behind Angela Yee back? But hey, I appreciate everybody for tapping in. Hit subscribe button, bell icon button, share the videos. But you do, you know, right, wrong, in between, or y'all don't like each other, you do owe your coworkers some type of loyalty and common courtesy. All right? And obviously, you know, they said that, you know, Gucci Mane wasn't banned from the Breakfast Club. But for him to have to interview Charlamagne the God on Charlamagne the God's YouTube channel, whatever platform he posted it on, shows that that's not true. And Charlamagne said, oh, you wasn't banned. It may not have been the word banned, you know, per se, where you can't come. But Envy already said, like, I'm not interviewing Gucci Mane unless Angela Yee cool with it. You know what I'm saying? And Angela Yee, in an interview she been doing this week, well, she been milking this story for attention. And that's what most women want. Women just don't want penal activity, you know. They want attention. You know what I'm saying? And she loved having all this attention. She ain't never had this much attention in her life. When she worked with the Wu-Tang, even when she was, you know, doing Nas' syndicated Breakfast Club show, and she's never had this much attention. Now, Gucci Mane gave her this attention for 31,000 streams and units moved, whatever they calculating what album sales these days is. He did this to boost his album, and it didn't hurt. It didn't help. All this did was give Breakfast Club more momentum. It gave it more... It gave them more publicity, you know what I'm saying? It gave them bigger clout, and it gave Angela Yee a bigger clout platforms. Now she walking down the street getting stopped, I'm just saying, by TMZ. Now she's stopping down the street and everybody want to interview. She relishing this moment. Trust me, she gonna eat up the drip, all this drip she get. She gonna slurp it all up. And I ain't mad at her, man. When you got momentum, capitalize on it. It could lead to a movie for her. It could lead for a new job for her or whatever. I'm not knocking her for getting attention, because she getting more attention than Gucci Mane album is. Well, October 2, which I ain't even heard one. That first Gucci Mane album he dropped when he got out of prison. Man, I heard a few people playing it when I worked at GM on their little, you know, high lows and stuff. Shit was trash. I downloaded and deleted it. I keep it real. And I'm a huge Gucci fan. Will Chamberlain, No Pad, No Pencil, Writing on the Wall. Writing on the Wall 2 was his last good mixtape. That's it. That was his last good project. Jury's Selection, The Appeal was dope. He had some dope shit. And people say, well, he put out 100 projects. People say, well, he just throwing shit out. No, he had some really good projects. Gucci Mane had my whole high school summer damn near on lock. Starting off with So Icy, going through all those, you know, albums he did. I ain't gonna front. He had it on lock. That's all the trappers in my neighborhood was playing. Was Gucci Mane. And Jeezy was getting played, but Gucci Mane had the hood on lock. You know, I remember he came into the club on 6 Mile and Schaefer, man. My friend's dad, he had a deal up there. We power washed the parking lot and we got paid for it. You know what I'm saying? As teenagers, shit, we didn't have no job at the time. We like 10th graders, 9th graders. So that worked out, but I'm a huge Gucci Mane fan, but he used Angela Yee for publicity. And Angela Yee got the most publicity. She capitalized off of it. But now she going around doing interviews and basically saying Charlamagne wasn't being loyal. At the end of the day, they know Charlamagne the God don't got no chill. You know what I'm saying? You don't expect loyalty out of a snake. Right? You don't expect to lose weight going to a pizza buffet like CeCe's or some shit like that. You know what you get out of Charlamagne the God. It ain't the first time he done violated or stepped over the parameters. You know what I'm saying? That's why Jay-Z got him fired. So at the end of the day, he capitalized off of it. He gave him an interview. You know, him and Gucci cool. You know, I do feel that he should have had some amount of respect for Angela Lee. Like, you know, I'm doing this interview. It is what it is. But she said she knew the interview was happening. So I don't know if she went to Charlamagne, was like, no, I don't do it. But she shouldn't have to. He should already know how she going to feel. But Charlamagne, the guy, don't care. He ain't studying no broad. If they get rid of him in the Breakfast Club breakup, he can get a job somewhere else. Making the same or if not more, a little bit less money. It just shows right then and there, like, he probably don't even look at Angela Lee like a sister or nothing like that. Some co-workers think, like, because we work together. I'm just saying this. We work together. Like, we cool. We going to kick it. Have drinks. I don't want to kick it with none of them niggas, man. Unless you my mans like that. You know, like, we knew each other coming in or we got a special bond. Like, I ain't trying to kick it. I'm trying to do my eight. Or do my 8 and skate or do my 10 and get out of here and get it in. That's all I'm trying to do. Some people think it's deeper than that, but it's really not. We work together. I got an opportunity to interview this dude just because you say you don't want to interview him. You don't want him at the Breakfast Club. Well, I'm interviewing him over here. You know what I'm saying? If I say some things you don't like, so cry 2 tears in the bucket. Fuck it. You know what I'm saying? But she's just doing this for attention. At the end of the day, if you knew the interview was coming on, you should have kind of shot a man and got like, I really don't approve of that. You know what I'm saying? He probably would have been like, I don't give a fuck. You going to cut me this check? You going to give me this money for the interview I'm about to get? So I feel him. Like sometimes coworkers really be thinking like we family. No, I'm just doing this job to eat and skate. You know, but, you know, she knew the interview was coming. So it wasn't like he was hiding or nothing like that. But, hey, you didn't want him up here. Shot a man to God. Found a way to get him up there. Hey, bros over hoes. I'm fucking with you, but I understand where she's coming from, but I understand what Charlamagne got. Now, if they're close like that, they kids play together, and they really like a tight-knit family outside the studio, then he was in the wrong. But if he really don't know, is he perceived on the radio to have no chill and not give a fuck? I don't think she can be mad, you know, but she can, women do that. Once you hurt them so bad, to the point where you done fucked up so bad with them. That could be in a relationship, a casual relationship, working relationship. They hold on to shit. Unless they really, really need something like, hey, I need my rent money or we got to work together, then they'll let it go. But once you hurt a woman to a point where they scorn and they ain't giving, they real, real hurt, you can forget about it. You can forget about it. You know what I'm saying? You definitely can forget about it, man. So if she at that point, you know, the Breakfast Club could be over with, or they can make some changes, but I think they'd get over it, man. Too much money to be made. They got too much momentum, even before the Gucci stuff. Let me know what y'all feel about it, man. I'll link the article in the description. Did a little short interview with somebody, Quicksilver, whatever his name is. But, hey, we on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter. Reach out to the email if you got business question, inquiry, response to the video quest. Want to make a donation, that link in the description. Best way to donate is share the video one time for the one time. It's your boy, CJ Goodfella, Goodfella Sports TV. We gone.